Let's get to another segment of the Writer's Block. Say what? Robert Kraft, the stately owner of the New England Patriots, arrested in a human trafficking sting, arrested for solicitation of prostitution in Jupiter, Florida. Out of all the stories that come around the pike, Cedric, this is one we did not see. What do you make of Robert Kraft getting caught up in this sex sting?
He had the nerve to go to the Oscars. I mean, this guy has no shame in his game. 77 years old. All I got to say, Barry, is Viagra is a hell of a drug. Good for Robert Kraft, but got to question the judgment of a guy who's worth $7 billion going to a seedy massage parlor. You know, that's not something I'm into. I can't speak for everybody, but if I could use just a little abstract example of it, if you're ordering pizza, if you're ordering from Domino's, why are you driving to Domino's? Aren't they supposed to deliver? I mean, I don't think there are going to be any FBI cameras in the Kraft mansion. So for him to be caught up out in the streets, pulling up at that to one of those seedy joints in a white Bentley, are you kidding me, Barry? I mean, what is this guy thinking? What do you think those investigators were thinking when they were watching the videotape and a white Bentley pulls up and Bob Kraft gets out of the back and rolls in there with a pocket full of hundreds? That's just nuts, man. Those stories write themselves.
Well, they do. If you work in that kind of law enforcement, you probably have seen it all. Here's what I wonder. How much does this stain the New England Patriot and the Robert Kraft legacy? You know, this is not a franchise that's been void of controversy. Bill Belichick with the Spygate, basically cheating. Tom Brady caught up in Deflategate with the footballs. You certainly didn't expect the owner to be all of a sudden making headline news, but now he is. It's just one thing after another with football's greatest dynasty. What do you think this does to the Patriot legacy?
What it does to the Patriots legacy is it's just another small blip on a gold-plated radar. Here's the thing. History is always much more forgiving, kinder, embracing of winners. If Bob Kraft was the owner of the – if he was Mark Davis, who hasn't won anything since his dad died, the Oakland Raiders – he'd be getting eviscerated. But he's Bob Kraft. He's got, what, 6 Super Bowl rings. Only the Steelers have the same amount. So he'll survive this. Rich men in America always survive scandals. This is a misdemeanor. He won't do one day in jail. He'll pay a hefty fine, release a statement saying that, you know, it happened. It's unfortunate. I'm sorry. Who do we play next?
You're probably right. Probably right. He will face some discipline from the NFL, a suspension, a hefty fine. The question is how much? That we don't know. Let's get to our final installment.
Yeah, you think about it, Barry.
Yes.
He'll get a fine. It'll be hefty. But last I checked, Bob Kraft has never thrown a touchdown pass. He's never made a tackle, and he's never run the football. The New England Patriots, as long as Belichick and Brady are running things, are going to be right where they need to be.